is up, everybody? It is Lifted, and in today's video we are wrapping up me and Joey's Go Fest experience, and we're just gonna show you a glimpse into how we spent our 2 days and the overall recap of the makeup day and everything. And I've been trading a lot of the shinies we received since then, so by now I have almost all of them on the main account. And I got quite a few lucky shinies, actually. We grinded the Gible raids to no success, but eventually we did come out on top with that shiny Gible. I got it on Joey's account during a raid when she was at work or something, and then I also got one on, like, the Dragon Week for the Ultra Bonus unlock. So, yeah, pretty good stuff. We got the shiny Gible. Here's the Rotom, as you can see. And, yeah, then we get into some shadow Pokemon and just stick around. There'll be a ton of shiny encounters, and if you stick around to the end, we also got the recap, the overall, like, inventory of what we got, the final result, and that little shadow Snorlax. We got some cool stuff. There was, like, wild Charizards and crazy stuff. We got all the shadow birds, which is kind of nice because me and Joey both didn't do any of those, so yeah, not bad. And you know, right after that we get a shiny. That's pretty sweet. And yeah, here we go. We're gonna battle Giovanni, and my god, did they make Giovanni super easy for the event. It was kind of a bit of a pushover, to be fair, but I guess they were making it so everybody can accomplish it. But as you can tell here, I just kind of run in with a Machamp and I shred through his Pokemon. So, easy money. We got the Shadow Persian that we're going to catch here momentarily. But let's just finish battling this bloke. He doesn't stand a chance. And yeah, Go Fest was overall a success. I don't really think we needed the makeup day. I don't know if whatever problems they were having were affecting us particularly. We were expecting the spawn rates for the shinies to be a little bit higher because, frankly, on, like, the first day, I only got, like, 6 or something on each phone or something. I'm not sure, but the second day, we really turned things around. I might have, like, tweeted out my first day one shinies, but I didn't really follow up to that. But, hey, we got a whole video here, so yeah, pretty good experience with Go Fest. I would do it next year if they do the same kind of format. Yeah, it was overall a good time. I think we got just like 70 shinies, was it, Joey? Something crazy like that? Between the 70 total between the three of us. Well, two of us, but three accounts. And then not including like all the additional ones from the Dragon Week and, you know. On a side note, there's the Mewtwo itself, the Shadow Mewtwo. Unfortunately, I forgot to TM Frustration away on, like, all of my Pokemon, but I did remember to at least do it on the Mewtwo. I knew I would forget, so I just did it right away, as you'll see momentarily, but yeah, I wasn't very smart enough to do it on the other legendary, like the birds and stuff, so that would have been a good idea, but, you know, forgot, so only so much you can do about that. But you know, a lot of good stuff we received through this event here, and now that I'm like putting all the footage together, it really amounted to something nice. It was pretty cool. Me and Joey had a good time. And yeah, the mythical Victini now, pretty sweet. You know, not useful by any means, but you know, at least we have it now for the decks. And is it lagging? Goddamn, what's going on? There we go. Okay. So, yeah, pretty good time. I'm just kind of rambling at this point. I might just, like, excuse me, I might just, play some music in the background if I run out of things to mention, but, you know, pretty good stuff. And, yeah, so I'm just gonna go through some shiny encounters next, and then we'll do shiny trades, and in the middle of the shiny encounters, I go on a little, or I give you a glimpse of where we were playing at, so it was pretty cool. And what is Joey doing there? Whoa. Okay. But yeah, tons of shinies, a lot of pink shinies actually, so Joey was probably pretty happy about that. And we did get all the shinies. We came out to I worded that weird. We got all the shinies we were trying to get at least, so that's pretty much all we really needed to accomplish. And yeah, so I'll have plenty of shinies for trade. Not sure if I'll be hitting up people, but I've started to do some lucky trades with people again after not doing that for like I don't know how long in quarantine. But yeah, this is pretty much where we're playing the event for the most part. It was a pretty good spot. We were playing at some mall that had like a lot of like opportunities to like drive amongst all the Pokestops and shit. There was a ton of people though, and none of them were wearing masks, so that was just a nightmare. So of course we didn't go outside until we were in a safe area. We got some green shinies now, if you saw that, and that's pretty cool. We got the Marowak coming up. We got way too many of these Alolan shiny Marowak. I think we got like four. And I even hatched an Alolan shiny from an egg, and then the shadow shiny, the unknown shiny, and now the shiny legendaries from the ultra bonus unlock thing. And I did get two Deoxys, and just the one of each for Genesect and Rayquaza, but I didn't really try too hard. I would have liked to get more shiny Rayquazas, or just do more raids of them in general, because I don't know. I don't have the perfect yet. I have five lucky shiny Rayquazas, but none of them really are worth maxing. I mean, two of them are lucky shiny 96s, so if I get a third one, I'll just have to make that the trio. But if I get something better than what you'll see momentarily, then I'll probably have to go for it. Yeah, so we're just doing some trades at this point, giving myself some duplicate ones so I can evolve it and have the full evolution line. And that Tangela, pretty sweet. I'm kind of glad it wasn't lucky because then I would have felt inclined to evolve it and max it out. But, you know, I just didn't do that. So, yeah, I was just trading some old Pokemon for these new shinies. And sure enough, a lot of them came out lucky shinies. So that's nice. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and power up this Muk for PvP. Pretty decent. Going to give it the new charge move. Not the best CP to land on, but you know, lucky shiny, I gotta do it. And here's the Exeggutor now. Pretty cool. Lucky shiny, I think this one was like 91%. I figured I might as well, because it doesn't like affect my organization for the top 12 or anything. And lastly, the Magmortar. So, yeah, three lucky shinies, there you go. There was more, as you'll see from the recap at the end, but you know, I wasn't lucky enough to get them all on screen recording. But yeah, Instamax, three Pokemon pretty much right there. So yeah, we got all sorts of things in this video. We're using Stardust, TMs, we're showing the experience, all the shiny encounters, some raid battles, some trades. So a little bit of everything. Probably gonna do a video for the Magikarp Community Day and maybe some like other things that you might have seen on the Lifted V2 channel. I've been getting into the habit of just uploading footage, so that'll be a little teaser at what's to come. And there's the Rayquaza I was also teasing at. 93%, you would think that's pretty good, but I think I can do better. So, fingers crossed for something at least 96 or better. And now for the recap, this is pretty much what we got between the five accounts. Three of them had the Go Fast Pass, but overall a success. I'll go through each of the accounts, Joey's account, so hopefully you guys enjoy. It's been Brandino and JoJo in the background if you caught that. So we out of here. Enjoy. Peace.